drinking ban is a huge step forward in tackling the effects of this problem. Aggressive begging, street drunkenness, urinating in public, all of these are being tackled head on. But this is only tackling the symptom and not the cause. If developers are building poor quality housing in the area, the problems will only get worse. I have attended the planning committee on at least six occasions to speak against inappropriate planning applications. Unfortunately, the committee does not have the ability to reject those applications. But Lord Mayor, the council has the power to set a higher standard. We can use our powers in the Town and Country Planning Act of 1990 to reject low quality conversions and protect the area from yet more poor quality bedsits. Before my election, I went round door to door with a petition calling on the council to use these powers. More than 850 residents signed my petition to demand better quality conversions and to demand that Tuebrook and Stoneycroft residents are offered not more bedsits and letting rooms, but one bedroom flats. Few would choose willingly to share their kitchen and toilets with 12 or 15 strangers. And the council has the ability to say no more. I firmly believe the best days for Tuebrook and Stoneycroft lie in the future and not in the past. I call upon council to support this motion. Thank you, Lord Mayor.
My Lord Mayor, can I move?
Can I ask, is it seconded?
Yeah. In moving amendment that is printed as Appendix E, I am not in any way disagreeing with any of the comments made by the former Speaker. But what has to be placed on public record is this Council had the opportunity and was formally asked to adopt Article 4 directions and controls on HMOs in Kensington, Tuebrook, Newsham Park, etc. by my colleague Councillor Hazel Williams on the 7th of November 2012. The Council chose not to implement it. They could have done so. I don't think it would necessarily have resolved all the problems we face, but we've made a major contribution. So we have, quite honourably, a new Labour member asked the Council to do something that Councillor Hazel Williams had already put to the Council. The fact is, since that motion by Councillor Hazel Williams was put to Council, I understand from the information provided kindly by Planning and Chief Executive, there have been over 400 HMOs granted licences. Now, I appreciate that statutory HMOs, and I'm also going to be fair to the administration. We all know the government changed ground rules on planning to HMO status for planning, and was changed from a threshold of six down to from three back up to six, and that was a principle. But I also have to disagree, having also attended probably more planning committees as an objector rather than as a member of the planning committee, the council does have powers to reject HMOs. Many of the applications in our ward that have been approved by the planning committee have had no parking, inadequate kitchen space. In some occasions, I use the example of number one, Newsham Drive, the council did a site visit. As a consequence, community space was put into an application. In the case of 91 Belmont Drive, only recently, I was horrified when the council committee members on the planning committee asked for a planning committee site visit because they were concerned about the local housing. It came back to the committee without the planning committee having done a site visit. The members of the planning committee were just, in effect, ignored at the decision they'd made. And I think that really is quite disconcerting. So I would respectfully disagree with the member's motion. The planning committee has had powers, and some of those applications, I believe, could have been rejected. And this planning committee has not rejected it on a significant number of times. I also have sat and supported the rejection of planning applications that are of a similar nature that have taken place in Greenbank Ward and Anfield. And on one or two occasions, applications have gone back, and to be the credit, because the objection of the ward members, the banking members, the quality of the housing has been improved. But I don't believe the planning committee, and I say that with respect, has been robust enough to use the powers to reject, which it does have. There are clear grounds, fire escapes, one case in Windsor Road, which is the fire escapes weren't put in on a site visit that was identified and the application was improved. In the case of Newsham, we had community space put in. That hasn't always been the case, and it could have been. As far as Article the Newcastle practice that was adopted by Newcastle to tackle HMOs, when Councillor Williams put it to the council, we were told we won't do it for Newsham Park, Stoneycroft, and in fact we'd also ask for Fairfield and Kensington, because they share a lot of the same problems across the border, because we've got to look at it as a citywide problem. But it hasn't happened. And this administration has had the opportunity, it's been put to them. If they do it now, I'll be absolutely delighted. But I will also put on record, I believe the planning committee has missed opportunities to reject applications over the last 4 years, and a lot of the HMOs of the poorest quality could have been and should have been rejected.
Thank you. Councillor Hunt.
Thank you, Lord Mayor. And I want to congratulate Councillor Sung on an excellent maiden speech. And particularly thank her for her work in her ward. It's a community she understands, it's a community she cares about. And it's obvious from the motion that she's brought to us today that she understands the community. I'm going to ask you to reject what I believe is an unnecessary motion. In fact, Councillor Bradford did it for me, actually said it was unnecessary. And I speak at this time simply to assure Councillor Bradford and other members that the citywide landlord licensing scheme is being pursued with vigour and will over time drive up standards in the private rented sector. But it's a journey, it's not an event. The scheme's only been in place a matter of months. That scheme and other measures, including some of the measures Councillor Radcliffe referred to, are part of a wider strategy to improve the quality of housing in the city, a strategy that this Labour administration has been pursuing since 2010. And a strategy that we will continue to give priority to. So I ask the members again to reject what I believe is an absolutely unnecessary amendment.
Councillor Robertson Collins, please. Many thanks, Lord Mayor. Yes, thank you very much to Councillor Sung. Well done for bringing this issue back before Council, and well done for a brilliant speech there. This is a motion, we have debated this issue before. I think one of the problems may be that it's an issue that disproportionately massively affects a very small number of wards, but the effect on those wards is absolutely incredible. So we've got Greenbank, we've got Tuebrook, we've got Kensington, where there's a massive overpopulation now. You know, when we have houses stuffed full of people, 10, 12 people rammed into houses where private landlords are trying to milk them for every penny they can. Far more people living there than there were actually in Victorian times when the houses were originally built, and that can't be acceptable in the 21st century. So I do actually share Councillor Radford's frustration in the sense that we haven't maybe been able to do as much as this so far as we can, but completely agree with Councillor Hunt that it's a journey that we're on. We don't need to agree the amendment because, as Councillor Radford correctly says, we've already agreed the motion that's held within it, and we've got Carol Sung's motion before us today. We have seen action lately. We've seen where we have the political world, there absolutely has been action. Councillor Hunt has mentioned the landlord licensing. That's a brilliant step in the right direction. In my own ward, we've had a to-let sign ban, and many thanks to Councillor O'Byrne for her support in that. That's made an incredible difference there. Councillor Roberts and I, within Greenbank Ward, are using the local plan process to try and get a ban in one area of our ward, in particular in the L15 part of Greenbank Ward, to have a ban on further HMOs. But you're absolutely right, Councillor Radford and Councillor Sung, we need to move to a process where granting an HMO licence is an exception and not that it absolutely happens on and on through, and that's the automatic agreement. So we need to change the policies, and we are going the right way about that. So thank the Cabinet Member's support for that, thank the Deputy Mayor's support for that. I thank the Councillor for bringing it here today, but we do need to be more proactive on this, and HMO granting those licences should be an exception.
Mayor Anderson?
Well, it's the fact that we've
got a cabinet member for housing, we've got the council houses, Councillor Kemp, so for that. But the reality is that we've got one. I didn't show them the commitments. I'm concerned because I don't recall Councillor Williams as former Councillor Williams as a motion. If you can get a copy of that, I'd be delighted to see it. But if that's the case, then you know, we hold our hands up. We should have done more. So no problem in saying that, because that's important to address. The issue, though, is that the motion is actually a way forward, and the amendment is not really that helpful, given the fact that we're conceding, if you like, that subject to seeing the motion, that we hold our hands up saying we maybe could have done more. But I'd also like the city solicitor, on your behalf, certainly on my behalf, to look at what decisions have been approved, which you say shouldn't have been approved or could have been rejected. I'd like to see if that's the case, because as far as I'm aware, one thing that I'm not going to do, or the planning committee is going to do, is reject an application that's a legal application, because that puts us all in serious trouble. But the reality is, I'm pretty convinced that the planning officers and the chair of planning would have only allowed something go through if the recommendation was made to planning committee based on legal facts. So I'd like that to be addressed and checked. But more importantly, I think we now all agree, that we need to take stronger, more consistent action to make sure that we address this, and this council is committed to that. So I hope Councillor Bradford withdraws the amendment, certainly from my point of view. If he doesn't, then we will vote against it. But I say that in the spirit of moving forward in unity.
Councillor Bradford, are you prepared to withdraw your amendment?
Actually not, because the record of fact has been disappointing.
Councillor Kennedy?
And thank the Mayor for those comments. I think he's absolutely right. But can I also give you congratulations to Councillor Sung on the speech that she made, because the one thing Councillor Sung recognised was the wide range of activity that needs to be taken place to deal with the problems that Tuebrook is facing. It's not simply a matter of planning. What's been happening over recent months, since April, 30 HMOs have been approved. Council officers are under instructions to be much tougher on actual HMO applications, and as a result, four were actually turned down. Of the four that were turned down, two went to appeal and actually won the appeal and therefore got their planning permission. That means two successful rejections were actually upheld on appeal. You see, what happens then is that the council, in its perilous financial situation, is faced with all the costs of successful appeals. And the Lord Mayor, as a former chair of planning, will know that very well. Article 4s of themselves are not the panacea, which is why Councillor Sung is right to point out why there's so many other actions need to be taken, because what Article 4s do is make simply more go to planning than would otherwise go to planning, and therefore, if you just turn planning applications down, you get a higher number of appeals, you get a higher number of supported schemes on appeal, and therefore, you get a greater amount of costs to the City Council as a result. So the call from the Mayor for an examination of each of the ones which have been turned down, or each of the ones that have been agreed on, that should have been turned down according to critics, is very welcome, because we can look at those and see whether there's a case to answer. Just very quickly, everybody be clear, when people mention Article 4, we're not talking about a method of turning down applications. We're talking about a rule that just makes more things go to planning committee. We have the power already. Planning officers have to be very tough on the applications, and as Councillor Sung again pointed out, the key thing is the quality of those applications. The ones that have been successfully turned down
were turned down very much on the quality of the application and of the loss of public amenity. Thank you very much.
Are there any other speakers? Councillor Sung, you do have the right to reply if you wish.
I'd like to thank everyone for those comments. Just wanted to say about all that's been said is right on. I think the business about Liverpool under Mayor Anderson has an enviable reputation for the progress we've actually made in housing. The issues in Tuebrook and Stoneycroft are unusual. Our very many large properties have had particular problems in the community, and we do have the power to make a difference. I think if we can show the residents that the council cares about the problems they face and take action, that will make a difference. And so, Lord Mayor, I ask my fellow councillors to support this motion. And thank you again for listening.
So, voting is on the amendment. Can we have all those in favour? All those against? Is there any abstentions? The voting is for the amendment 6, against 75, no abstentions. The amendment is lost. Can we move on now to the substantive motion? Can we agree with that? Okay. Motion 12, the trade union bill by Councillors Johansson and Frank Hart. Can I invite Councillor Johansson to move the motion standing in the committee?
Move the motion. Sorry, move the motion. No, ma'am. Lord Mayor, colleagues. The problem with motions like this is that you get something like bad tendencies. Who comes along and does a fabulous contribution, and doing so seals out your prepared speech. And then you've got some colleague, Mayor Anderson, who comes along and seals the other half. So thank both of my colleagues and my friends. I have to say I'm disappointed this motion does not have the full support of the council. Disappointed but not surprised, I guess. We see before us today a motion opposed on trade union bills going through Parliament. The bill, in my opinion, seeks to destroy the effectiveness of trade union in this country. I believe the bill will be described as the love child of Thatcher, former Prime Minister of this country, who waged war on its people and its communities, and in doing so effectively destroyed thousands of lives and destroyed communities across the length and breadth of this country. David Cameron has picked up where she's left off and is determined to destroy what she couldn't. This bill says the private sector would require a 50% turnoff in industrial action. In the public sector, it demands 40% of all trade unions, trade union members, and then purely non-voters would be counted as being against industrial action. I suppose if you turn that on its head, and we said that in the general election or local elections, all no voters would be none of the above. This democracy in this country would be in a right mess, wouldn't it? But hey, such is life. I'm not going to go through all the bits and pieces because I know some of my colleagues want to make contributions, and between the Mayor and perhaps they haven't left much for anybody to contribute on. The sticks is on pickets, and I just find it's amazing. Back in the 70s, when I was an extremely young shop student in Forbes, I was asked to go up to Pilkington Zoo, who never had a dispute, never had a strike, to list the buyers among and how they conduct themselves on picketing. I've been here about a quarter an hour, and you see a big hairy plainclothes people pick me up by my shoulders, turn me in the back of a van, and took me off to St. Helens police station. I stayed about 2 hours until one of my old-style officials come on the bounce and explained to the police the errors, the ways and whatever. And I've been on many picket lines over my years involved in the trade union. And in broad brushstrokes, you work, you have to work with the police. You have